This week in the Parsha, we're going to be learning about the last three plagues, and those last three plagues are actually hinted to in the first part of the Parsha, where it says, Bo El Paro. Bo is the gematria, the letter Beis is 2, the letter Aleph is 1 is 3, is a total of 3, so therefore Bo El Paro, Hashem is telling Moshe, go to Paro, there's going to be 3 more things you're going to tell him, 3 more plagues are going to happen. When it comes to the plague of darkness, amazing thing, so the Medrash explains, what was this plague of darkness? It wasn't just simply that the sun didn't shine, rather the plague of darkness was some other type of either thick substance, as Rashi points out, it was a thickness, it was palpable, which we would called the Han Solo type of darkness, where they're frozen, nobody can actually move, and the Egyptians end up becoming frozen. It was something that happened over this 6-day period, where it was getting increasing more, not just dark, but thicker upon the people, and therefore they couldn't actually move at that point. They actually had to have those that were standing, those that were sitting, they were frozen in place. It was a debilitating plague that actually happened to them. The Medrash explains, according to the view of Rabbi Yehuda says, this darkness actually came from the heavenly abode. It wasn't coming from a place of negativity, but rather it was coming from a place of the heavenly abode. What does the heavenly abode mean? It means heaven, everything in Shemayim, everything related to that of God is something that's purely light. It means the concept of light is something that radiates, it gives, it nurtures, it creates. And therefore, if that is so, if everything in heaven represents a concept of life and sense of giving, so how does this darkness actually work? So what the commentaries tell us, and the Medrash explains, and the footnotes tell us as well, is that when you look at the 10 plagues, that each of the 10 plagues correspond to the 10 utterances as to the way the world was actually created. Some of the commentaries explain through, I know of 3 of them, but basically explain this concept that the plague of darkness, which is the second to last plague, actually corresponds to the second utterance in the creation of the world. So the first utterance of the creation of the world is that of Bereshis Bara, that God created the world. The second one is that Vahi Or, behold, there was light. What corresponds to that? So the first one, Bereshis Bara, that God created, is the essence of creation itself. The opposite of that creation is the essence, was basically what we'd call death, which is the plague of the firstborn. So working backwards, if the first one is the plague of the first utterance, which represents life, now corresponds to the plague of the firstborn, which is death. So the second utterance, which represents light itself, which is Vayehi Or, and behold, there was light, the opposite of that would actually be Choshech, would actually be darkness. That's the second to last plague. So the commentaries point out that all 10 utterances that existed in the beginning of creation, those now are going to have the opposite effect when it comes to the plagues that are going to be given over to the Egyptians. And therefore, so if that is so, that they correspond, it's nice that they correspond, but what the commentaries say, that the same ones in creation are the same ones that actually created the destruction for the Egyptians, which means as follows. The Or Gedaliah presents the idea, the light which was created at the beginning of creation, that light is the light that was saved for the righteous in the future. What does that mean? That light was given over to Adam. Adam was able to see from one end to the other to the other. He was able to see and know everything that exists within the world. That is what we know as the Or HaGonos, a hidden light that was eventually put away for the end of days for the righteous tzaddikim. What that means, though, is that Or HaGonos, which was there created, that hidden light which was created at the beginning of creation, that was unleashed at the time of the second to last plague, the plague of darkness. And what that happened was, it meant that it was debilitating and it destroyed the Egyptians because they were not ready for that type of light. But yet the righteous ones of the generation, the Jews at the time, they were actually able to have this ultimate essence of radiance, that hidden sense of goodness that emanated from the Jewish people. That was from the beginning of time, that came from what we know as the Or HaGonos, that was that ultimate radiance that came from the beginning of creation. And therefore the verse says over there that for the Egyptians they couldn't see anything, but the rest of the Jews, there was light in all of their dwellings. How you Or B'Moshe Hashem, they're able to see. What was they able to see? Of course they're able to see. They didn't have darkness. The answer is they were able to see the same way that Adam and Eve were able to see in the beginning of creation. Unbelievable. You can understand this concept there. They were able to see at that moment They understood what the world is about. They can see from one end of the earth to the other. They had this primal vision that Adam had at that time. They had no physical barriers. They had another worldly vision, almost as if those people were able to see all the heavens and earth all at the same time during that time of the plague of the firstborn. This is what it means, that the light came from heaven. It wasn't just simply they had light. That light which was destroyed those that were unworthy and that froze those who were unworthy actually gave those that were worthy an ultimate vision they can see in the entire world.